We're delighted to see you all, and a special welcome back to our wonderful choir, Rochester. It's great to have them back. Especially Darren, who I know, our director of music, is not very well at all, but he's like a good soldier. He's turned up and he's on the organ, so thanks to them too. So we start with our public appearance. Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate the presence of Christ in word and sacrament, let us call to mind and confess our sins.
Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you in judgment, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault.
We are truly
sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all his past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Thank you.
open for us a new and living way into your presence. Give us pure hearts and steadfast wills to worship you in spirit and in truth. In Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armour of light. Let us live honourably as in the day, not in revelling and drunkenness, nor in debauchery or licentiousness, nor in quarrelling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For wherever two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among you. This is the gospel of the Lord. She and her husband had reached the conclusion that they were both misfits, unlike her parents, and separation as the best solution to their problem. Fortunately, she had the courage to tell her mother of their mutual decision. Only to be rocked on her heels when her mother told her that she and her father did indeed fight frequently, but that years ago they had taken the decision never to let any of their children witness their squabbles. This has resulted in the children growing up never knowing how to achieve conflict resolution, and consequently reaching a conclusion that they were terrible people, unlike their perfect parents. As a result of the conversation with her mother, the couple have decided to pause their move towards a divorce and to persevere in their marriage, perhaps. As far as I know, they're still together, and their children understand the meaning of conflict resolution and how to achieve it. In the early 1980s, I was working on a Billy Graham crusade at Bramall Lane in Sheffield, and he said one night that the best way to use a marital disagreement was for one party to say, "I'm sorry, I was wrong, I love you, forgive me." And it didn't matter which one said those words, whether it was the one on the right or the one on the wrong. Today's gospel passage comes after the parable of the lost sheep, and before Peter's question about how often you must forgive a brother or a sister who repeatedly sins against you. Jesus says that being a member of the church, you have a responsibility. Jesus stresses the power of agreement, saying that if anything is agreed by two on earth, it will be done for them by the Father in heaven. But notice, this isn't where Jesus ends. He goes on to say, "Where two or three are gathered together in my name, I'll be with you, and there I am there." Jesus is present, is really present, when two or three are gathered in divine name. And it even includes those who don't listen to each other about matters of sin and event, or even there, perhaps there, Jesus is present. This passage could not be more fitting for Christian communities in every age, place, and situation. Our ability to handle confrontation and disagreement isn't all that good at times. We simply don't know how to live together, fight together, and say it. This is because of what it says. But don't worry. Because Jesus has promised to each of us, you and me, that he is always with us. So when in doubt, lean on him, and he will be there.
Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, come from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and our salvation
in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
Your word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Accept our offerings of praise and teach us your ordinances. Sovereign God, you search us and know us. May we rely on you in strength and rest in you in our weakness. We pray for the renewal of your holy church here on earth in faith, love and service for this beautiful church and people. For our priests who faithfully administer the sacraments, for sensitivity and courage. Keep us aware of the need of all people to know they are of value, leaders and holders in the palm of your hand. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, we pray for peace, justice, and reconciliation throughout the world. For the relief of the oppressed, those affected by violence and abuse in our towns and cities and in the world. We pray for prisoners of conscience, for those torn from those whom they love, for the persecuted, those imprisoned for their beliefs, for asylum seekers and refugees, those who have no voice. We hold up to all victims of war and violence, praying for the people of Ukraine still under aggression from Russia, and for many other countries known to us in dispute and distrust. We bring before you all who are affected by floods, famines, wildfires and disasters across Europe. Especially at this time, we hold up to you the people of Morocco having a severe earthquake on Friday this week, for those injured and for those lives lost. We thank you for all police and public services, hospitals and emergency services throughout the world. We hold up to you all families who find it hard to manage to make ends meet. We thank you for our food banks and those who give to them, for all volunteers who seek to serve their fellow man. Let not our spirit and hope be broken, but stay on your strength. Grant that we who dwell secure in this insecure world may be generous in our caring for our displaced sisters and brothers. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Loving God, we call to mind our family's friends and neighbours, thanking you for the nurturing we have received and praying for our children and young people as they grow. Protect them from evil and strengthen them in faith. May they continue to be yours forever. Lord, in your mercy.
In your
hand. Compassionate God, give comfort and healing to all in any kind of need, sorrow or pain. We pray for those who ask for our prayers and for those who minister to their needs. For Isabel Skate, Isabel Pacheco, Sheila, Christopher, Alan, Ben, Emily, Jean, Cammy Christopher, Anne, Wendy, Lawrence, Janet, Sue, Monica, Judith and Carol, George and Reverend Susan. May they sense your reassuring presence and know that you are with them wherever their journey takes them. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful God, gather into your eternal kingdom all who have come to their earthly life. We remember all whom we love and see no more. We pray for the recently departed, for Margaret Wright, Dean Batty, Barry Bruce, Violet May Radcliffe, and for Adelaide Newton, Leslie Barker, Helen Elizabeth Chapman, Kenneth De Rosiaro. Whose anniversary occurs at this time. Also, we remember the good love Queen Elizabeth II, who died a year ago this week. Bless and comfort those who mourn. Lord, in your mercy. We pray that our prayers be accepted through Christ, in whose name we are gathered together. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers. For the sake of your Son, our
We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed be God, by whose grace creation is renewed, by whose love heaven is opened, by whose mercy we offer our sacrifice of praise. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed a resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. The same way after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Mystery of faith.
Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory to yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Oh, we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his Son.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
We do not presume
to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and that our souls washed through his own precious blood, and that we may abroad dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
pray.
Lord God, the source of truth and love, keep us faithful to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, united in prayer and the breaking of bread, and one in joy and simplicity of heart. In Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mighty God,
we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Well, the notices are all in your sheets, but I'll just highlight one or two of them, and again reiterate a warm welcome back to the choir and we've missed through the summer. It's lovely to see them again, and especially Darren, of course, who's turned up like a good soldier, even though he's not one. Just brought to your attention that heritage open days, 8th to 17th of September, will be open at our usual times. But we've got displays showing the history of our lovely church, so please have a look at them. They're worth looking at. Other than that, regarding the picnic club, if you'd like to take part in that, it's coming up for completion shortly, so please fill in the form and pay the £12 before the 18th of September, because the first draw will be on Sunday the 24th of September. For more detail, just pick up the form on the table at the crossing. There are no hands today, so that's it for me. Thank you. encompasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.